Is the mic close enough?
Is it close enough to what?
To you. Do
To
you want to move
me?
it closer that way?
No, this is fine.
Okay.
I was just leaning back.
Okay.
But now I usually sit up a little bit. Oh, wait. Yeah, good chair noise in there. That's always good. It was good.
Oh, the first Fast and the Furious? That's what you're asking?
No, the mic.
Mike,
Check.
it's good.
Mic, okay. No, first Fast and Furious. I don't give a shit about that. That time again. Time for official new for 2017 announcements. And I tell you, they're doing this shit earlier and earlier every year. We are so unprepared here. We couldn't even get Thanklin in this year because it's just such short notice. We weren't ready for this at all. So we apologize ahead of time. We have nothing prepared. I haven't even looked at all this stuff yet, so we're going to get some honest reactions. Let's just see what's going on. This episode is going to be all about Six Flags. What the Six Flags parks are doing for 2017. They did their big dump. Every park's been announced. It's all official. We did a rumor show, which is unusual for us, but this is not rumor, folks. This is the real deal. Get ready. Hold on to your butts. Because we got some bad news for you. Where is he? Bad News Barrett. The character that didn't last.
I'm afraid I've got some bad news!
I gotta say at the top, this has gotta be the most uncreative and uninteresting announcement year for Six Flags, maybe ever. For me, personally. The way I feel about it.
I think I'll have to agree with that. It's so whatever. Everything they've announced for all the parks is so whatever.
Well,
we told you so.
We so called it in the rumor show. We called it. You can just, you know what the parks are going to get now, 17, 18, maybe 19 at least, because they're just whatever the two or three things that they're doing around the chain, whatever park didn't get that yet is getting it this year. And it's just a rotation. So we probably shouldn't have let off with that because now you have no incentive to listen. Because if you have knowledge, if you have prior knowledge, and I think our listeners usually do, like the two of them, the two or three of them are guys with prior knowledge. So you probably know what we're talking about, but we'll go through it.
Yeah. And we're going to try and get through these pretty quick because
it won't take long.
Like you just said,
it's all stuff we've talked about before. You've heard our thoughts on it. Just listen to a prior episode.
Let's start with the Justice Leagues. Three more parks getting a Justice League.
Here we go.
Six Flags Great Adventure, Six Flags Magic Mountain, and Six Flags Over Georgia.
Georgia.
Now, we gave a ton of thoughts already on the Great Adventure one in our rumor show, but just to recap a couple of those quickly in case you didn't hear it.
Talk about Magic Mountain, too, there.
Yeah, yeah.
We mentioned it.
Justice League is a great ride. Great Adventure needs a dark ride. So this will be good for the park.
Yeah.
But it's something that we're coining here. It's the Batman the Ride effect.
Yes.
Where if you put in this ride, even though it's a great ride, if you put it in too many times, it waters down the experience. It makes it less special.
Yeah. Or at least for us. For those of us that travel around to all the parks. It's really unfortunate. Six Flags just really regionalizing themselves more than ever these days. They really want to just make every park the same, so you only have to go to one. Which, not a great strategy if you ask me. But it is true, Great Adventure could use a dark ride. Magic Mountain, even more so, could use a dark ride. So in that sense, it's good. Over Georgia, they have one already. They're one of the original three with their original dark ride. That's seen an upgrade or two. It's, what's the Monster Mansion now?
Yeah, Monster Mansion.
And it's actually not bad.
I like that ride a lot.
So, they don't need a dark ride as badly. But I guess every park's going to get one eventually, every Six Flags park. So I guess it's their turn this year. So three. This is most ever, right? Most ever in 1 year. Three in one season.
I think it is, yeah.
They haven't done three. They've done two. They haven't done three.
Yeah.
Wow. And they're going to go up to, they're going to double the number, right? So there'll be six.
There'll be...
chain-wide?
Seven if you count Mexico.
Okay. They're going to be everywhere.
Yeah, they will be.
Now, is there something new about one of them, though? Did I go crazy? Did I have a dream?
I know what you're talking about. I'm looking on the Six Flags website, and I don't see anything about that.
Is that rumor, then?
So, yeah, I don't know.
Not unconfirmed. Okay. And it's only one. I want to say, was it the Magic Mountain one?
Magic Mountain
one. They were saying they were going to do something.
Magic Mountain one is rumored to be different. I don't know if it actually is. I can't find info on the Six Flags website. It makes me think, shouldn't they all be?
Everyone should be different.
Yeah, shouldn't that be the case?
Again, there's enough DC characters that you could just focus on different ones in the different parks.
Yeah, why not? They're not doing that, yeah.
Come on, Jim Doofy. More like Jim Lazy.
Hello, my name is John Duffy. I'm the new president and CEO of Six Flags.
John, more like John Lazy. What do they keep changing these guys for? His name used to be Jim. Right? Jim Dick Anderson? No?
Hi, I'm Jim Reed Anderson, chairman, president, and CEO of Six Flags.
So this is tough. We were saying it's good-ish.
I mean, on this night, it's just disappointing is what it is.
Yeah.
Even with the Great Adventure announcement, it's maybe if we hadn't gotten to Great America, if we'd only ridden the one, we did it twice in one day, but just that one day, and then we still hadn't done it again yet, and then Great Adventure was going to be our second. Maybe that would be something, but even having done the second installation already, it's like, it's a shame. Because again, we know there's not going to be anything different about it.
Yeah.
We already know exactly what it's going to be. So whatever, there we go.
That's it. So those are your Justice Leagues.
There is no justice in Six Flags new ride announcements.
They're not doing this ride type justice.
No, they're not.
Dark Ride Adventure. All right.
Yeah.
Another threesome here.
Ooh, I like threesomes.
Three SNS 4D free fly coasters going in.
Okay.
All named the Joker.
All right. Let me stop you right there. It's actually the SNS 4D free spin coaster.
Oh, really?
That is actually the name that SNS gave it. And in the end, it's their creation, so you have to go with what they want to name it.
Okay, I don't know where the hell this free fly bullshit came from.
From Lance.
Oh.
Everyone's doing it. Because Screamscape keeps reporting them as free fly. The free fly coaster is another model that's actually like a family model.
Oh.
It's not in this country. But it's like a suspended thing where it keeps flipping back and forth from left and right side. I don't know why that keeps happening, but on Screamscape it keeps being reported as it's not.
All right.
So it's good a little to know. Thing. It's a little fact there for you.
The three parks that are getting the 4D free spin
there you go.
Coaster are Great America, New England, and Over Texas. So we already know that in New England, they're taking out Splashwater Falls.
Yes.
And I guess they're going to put Joker there. I would have to assume that.
Right, so they're all called Joker. That's really unfortunate. Mm. So, it's kind of funny. All these years later... after Batman became synonymous with one particular ride, Joker finally gets his, and now, so eventually they're going to be like 10 of these.
It looks that way.
And they're almost all going to be called Joker.
Yeah.
Except the one on Fiesta Texas, which also is the same. The Batman the Ride model that's in Fiesta Texas is not called Batman the Ride.
Yeah, that's funny.
Yeah. And then that's the one part that goes against the grain.
Yeah.
But all the rest will be called Joker. So there you go. I mean, that's unfortunate. I mean, I love Joker, but you give him this kind of shelf model, and these rides have no theme.
No.
Really?
No, they don't.
You're just slapping the Joker's name on it and some flags that say Joker on them. That's all you're doing. You're not really giving the Joker real justice. You know, like the greatest, most iconic comic book villain of all time, and you're not giving him well-themed, immersive rides. Granted, he is the star of Justice League, so he does get that, but anyway. The ride itself, it's the same ride.
Yeah, we've given our thoughts on it.
Same ride you've done before. Yeah.
It's really extreme. One of the most extreme things I've ever done. Rides more like a flat ride than a coaster. Flips are harsh, but it's smooth.
It is smooth. It
is not a rough ride.
It's comfortable.
Yeah.
The restraints are comfortable. It is cool. I do like it.
And yeah, that's the thing.
I want to see something different, though.
Right.
In other parks. It's like, it's in Great Adventure. And this, they did it. We talked about it on the rumor show. Great Adventure, New England in particular, close. They're kind of close. And you're doing the same ride in two parks that are pretty close, you know.
Not only that, they're doing Over Texas and Fiesta Texas.
That's true. Again, two very close parks.
Why? Why would you do that?
Oh, man.
You are really not thinking about this.
Those might even be closer. Nah, about the same distance maybe as New England and Great Adventure. They're both about four hours apart. Yeah, they're about the same. But, I mean, come on, guys. They really don't think anyone drives any more than like an hour to go to a Six Flags park?
They're thinking, we'll save a couple of bucks. This is an easy installation. We've done it before. Because I'm sure they're getting deals from these manufacturers by ordering so many.
Buy in bulk.
So,
but the same ride everywhere, at every park. What are you doing? So how many Ring of Fires are there going to be? How many?
looks like they stopped that.
Super Loops. So, well, because they pretty much maxed it out. So no Super Loops this year, huh?
No, it doesn't look that way.
Mm.
Two.
What do we got? Two
giant frisbee style rides.
Two giant frisbees. Which kinds? Who we got? They don't say, right? Then I can announce that.
No, I think it's reported that they're Zamperla giant discoveries.
The Zamps. A couple of Zamps, huh? Well, why not go inferior?
The Husk Giant Frisbee is incredible. I can't say about the Zamperla giant discovery. Because I haven't done one.
I don't think we've done one.
Yeah. So not
Kennywood.
Sure.
Kennywood has one.
Oh, really?
We didn't get on that one, though.
Oh, they screwed us on that. Remember that?
They closed it early. That's right.
Yeah. We should have gotten that one.
By all rights, we should have, yes.
So, I like these types of rides. The giant frisbee ride.
Yeah, these took a little longer to catch on. For the longest time, only the two in the same state of Ohio.
Yeah, at Cedar Point and Kings Island.
And then now all of a sudden they're catching on and everywhere you're getting them, which is not a bad trend. I guess the only criticism of this really is this, the Six Flags trend of replicating the same ride across all the parks, and that's the only problem with that. But
yeah, I do like, though, that Six Flags is putting in some flat rides every season to some of their parks.
Yeah,
it seems like that's what they've been doing lately.
That's a good point. Not just doing coasters, doing flat rides.
And I like that.
They do need flats in pretty much all their parks, so that is good. This is a good flat ride installation. It's a good model to pick.
And so this is going in, one's going in La Ronde, and one's going in Discovery Kingdom. The La Ronde one is called Titan. And the Discovery Kingdom one is called Wonder Woman.
Solid French name.
Lasso of Truth.
That's the Lasso of Truth. Okay. They're not going to call it Discovery? Isn't that the model name, right?
Yeah, they didn't want to do that.
Zamperla Discovery at Discovery Kingdom.
Now, this is not the only Lasso of Truth going in, but we'll get to that.
Oh, no. Okay. This isn't terrible. I was just making fun of the Super Loops, but I have more of a tolerance for putting in the same ride across your chain when it comes to flat rides, because that's not as big a deal. I think, you know, there's only a handful of really awesome, spectacular flats, at least ones that work in parks, you know, ones that are the best for park models. So, you know, in some ways, every park almost should have one. So I don't really mind that as much. I'll give them kind of a pass on that. That's kind of like, you know, I want to still see zero wave swings in every park.
Right,
I'm not going to say they shouldn't be in pretty much every park like they are. And so, okay, I'll give it to them with that. I guess when it comes to coasters and dark rides, it's kind of like, that's where I really want to see the variety. I don't want to see the same roller coaster in every park.
Yeah, because it's like your flat rides are your...
They're your side dishes.
That's your corn, man. That's an interesting way of putting it.
That's your corn and string beans.
Your corn and string beans, your potato or rice. That's
your classic potatoes, yeah.
It's your foundation, and then you build off of that.
Right.
with your big, you know, custom coaster or custom dark ride or something.
Yeah, you can go between the same few side veggies, but you want your unique main course rotating every night.
Right, it's like you can have potatoes as a side dish with every meal.
You could have it like four times out of the week.
Right. You can do that, but you wouldn't necessarily want just like a grilled piece of chicken every night as well.
You don't want that same teriyaki grilled chicken every night. You want to rotate it up.
Yeah.
You want to get, you know, your steak one night, and then you get your, if you like seafood, maybe, I don't, but if you want to see, you got your shrimp some other night, then you want to have your pizza with potatoes on it. Like
Bernie O
does. You know, you gotta mix it up.
The other lasso of truth is a Star Flyer. They stopped putting these in for a year or two, right?
And it took a break on these for at least 1 year.
Six Flags America is going to get Wonder Woman Lasso of Truth Star Flyer.
How tall, though?
242 feet.
That's not bad.
So, yeah. That's, they're not getting the 400-foot one, but they're not getting like a...
the 100-something foot like the other parks. Like, that's all they've done, right? They've done like the 100 ones and then like the giant ones, the 400.
Whatever, 242 is very respectful.
Or like Grand Adventure advertises like something like that, but it's not.
They advertise like 300 or something, but it feels like it's 100. I don't know what the hell's going on with that.
It's not as tall as the Ferris wheel, right?
It's not.
We figured this
out. It's really weird.
The Ferris wheel's like right next door, and it's not even as tall. They totally lied on that one.
They did. Come on. At the end of it, it says, please exit towards the teacups.
Yeah, something.
And they're not over there.
that was made for another park. I don't know.
Yeah, it really was.
Yeah, the crazy cups, right? I think it's crazy cups.
Oh, exit towards the crazy cups. The crazy cups.
It's like, where are the crazy cups?
And I think, didn't we try and look up where the crazy cups are, and they just like don't exist in any Six Flags any park part or of the something chain? Like that?
It was something. No, was it Georgia maybe has a crazy cups ride? It was something like that.
Oh, never mind. Okay, apparently it's in, there's crazy cups in Great America, New England, and Great Escape.
Three crazy cups. So there's only one Star Flyer?
Just one Star Flyer. That's right. It.
Because it's like the last one.
Yeah.
Probably. Or no, Great Escape doesn't have one.
Oh, all right.
They didn't do that. And Magic Mountain didn't. I don't think Magic Mountain got a Super Loop either, right? Because they don't get anything that's not a coaster until now.
Right.
Until this year, finally. They've always been kind of the odd ones out.
Six Flags St. Louis is getting a Zamperla Disco.
All right, so what's next? Is that even worth announcing? Why don't you just do it?
No, not really.
Just put it in over the winter, and everyone will be surprised. Don't even advertise that. Oh, it's Cold Spin Sanity!
It's Cold Spin Sanity.
I do like that name.
It's not Harley Quinn Spin Sanity, like, at Over Texas.
It's Spin Sane!
Yeah, that's those rides stink. So, the Zamperla Disco stinks. So
yes, Zamperla Disco stinks. Awkward position, awful restraints.
Yeah, it's not fun.
Hit your lower back, not good.
Yeah, Great Escape is getting some water slides. Fiesta Texas getting a water coaster type ride. Thunder Rapids.
I got excited when I read this one because I thought for a second. I mean, I wasn't really thinking because Fiesta Texas has rapids already, but regardless of that, I just saw that someone's getting a rapids, and I'm like, oh, they're getting a new rapids. First one since Grand Rapids. But they're using the rapids name for a water coaster, which is weird. But what's more weird is this is a water park ride, right? This is not a park ride.
Right.
It does, for a water park ride, you know, for as water park rides go, this looks cool.
This is actually the most unique thing they're putting in.
All across the chain?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. It is. Because it looks like it's a new form. It's not one of the ones we've seen before.
Right. It's supposed to be, some sort of different technology with how it propels the raft.
It looks more akin to the original idea of the water pushing you up.
Like water jets, yeah.
Like the Master Blaster, the original Master Blaster. You know, we've ridden that. We've also ridden one of the ones that came later, like the second gen, which was the Limbs. We've ridden one of those, too. And they're both good.
Mm-hmm.
Although I kind of enjoyed Master Blaster more.
Yeah,
it just seemed to be more consistent. It just gave a better ride. So I actually could be excited for this if there was any chance in hell that I was ever going to go to Fiesta Texas's water park, which there really isn't. But because it's not a place I'm going to be going very much ever. And, you know, if I'm going to do a water park in that state, it's probably going to be Schlitterbahn. So, again, it's like, why am I ever going to be there for the water park? I'm not. But whatever. If current Six Flags strategy teaches us anything, it's going to be there's going to be 10 more of these anyway. So I'm sure every Six Flags water park will get one of these pretty soon. And they'll all be called Thunder Rapids.
Guaranteed.
So there you go.
And then Six Flags Mexico, they're going to get the virtual reality coaster bullshit. And they're going to get some sort of, I don't know, parade or something, some Mardi Gras festival thing. And that's it. There you have it. So I won't remember any of this tomorrow because it's so unexciting.
I know what you mean. I won't forget because it's like it's so bad that it's memorable.
Okay.
Because it's and it's not even bad. None of these installations, give or take a Mardi Gras parade, are awful on their own. But oh no, actually disco. Okay, so besides a couple, most of these installations aren't awful on their own, but it's just the whole, it's the chain doing the same thing in every park, and that is really impossible to get behind, you know, but I do like Dark Ride Adventures going into a lot of the parks, and yeah, I mean, the SNS 4D free spin, it's cool.
But it's not something that every park needs.
No, it's not. We got to get this guy. Who is this? Jim Duffy. What is his name? John.
John Duffy.
John Doofus. Got to get him on the phone over here. I mean, I really want to, like, pick his brain. And why do they really think, like, we're just going full-on regional now? Or like, it's gone regional already, so it's out of our hands, so we'll just play to that. Where are their heads at? I don't get it. Like, they really think, like, no one is traveling from one Six Flags to the next. I mean, they still have it where they build into the season passes that you can go to all Six Flags, which encourages you to do that and only makes it more likely that you're going to visit at least the next closest to your home within any one summer. And even within the pairings now, they're starting to do like the same rides, you know, Great Adventure in New England and Vista Texas and Over Texas. Even St. Louis and Great America, they're a little bit, that's like more of a 5 hour than four. That's an extra hour, but still it's within driving distance, and it's just the same thing in every park. I don't know what they're thinking.
No Rocky Mountain conversion for 17.
Oh,
looks like they taking a year off on that.
Wow, that's okay. Wasn't even thinking about that. I'm not sorry. This mm-hmm. goes along with what I said on the rumor show when we talked about Mean Streak. Yeah, that's interesting. No Rocky Mountains this year. I wonder if Rocky Mountain spreading themselves too thin in 2016 had anything to do with that. Like, did Six Flags even call them and ask? And did they, for the first time, did they say, you know what? I'm sorry, we just can't right now. Like, are they retooling a little bit after this sort of a bit of a disaster season for them?
Maybe, because as far as we know, to date, is Rocky Mountain doing anything for 2017? Did anyone call them?
Oh, are they not doing any jobs? Well, I know what they're doing. They're opening Lightning Rod.
Yeah.
A fabulous new launched, first ever launched wood coaster at Dollywood. It barely got open this year. It could still be closed for all I know. I never really saw anything about it.
Yeah, I don't know. I think it was closed more than it was open.
It's one of those, yeah. So.
Yeah, Rocky Mountain did four projects in 2016, and that was way more than they can handle, clearly.
So Rocky Mountain, not
because
having an installation, not only not in Six Flags, but not at all.
I think Storm Chaser at Kentucky Kingdom opened fine, but I know Joker at Discovery Kingdom had some issues, and of course Lightning Rod was a whole disaster.
It had some kind of major problem where they had to, like, shut it down and wait for parts.
Yeah.
Right? It was a big, pretty big thing.
Wait, which one are you talking about?
Joker.
Oh, Joker. Okay.
Right. And then, well, Lightning Rod, of course.
And then they did one in Sweden. I don't know how, if that one turned out okay. But yeah, just a little bit too much. So, and I don't think they have a thing going on for 17.
Wow.
I don't know. It looks like no one's really putting in coasters for 2017 anyway. It's like it's not a big coaster year.
17 is going to be a dark year for those of us who love roller coasters.
Yeah.
We have two GCI though.
It's kind of interesting.
It's like, what is it, 1998?
Yeah.
what's going on here? Two GCI, but zero Rocky Mountain, which they were just recently hit big, but zero B&M in this country.
No Intamin either, right?
Zero Intamin? Come on, someone always makes that mistake and calls them for some bullshit. And you're really telling me no Intamins this year in the United States of America, as far as we know.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, as far as we know.
Wow. Yeah, this is not going to be the year of the coaster, 2017.
No.
I'll tell you that.
I mean, with what we know so far, there's very little that's getting me excited across the entire country.
It's not going to be a good year for new stuff, for brand new stuff.
Yeah.
We'll have to find our own new stuff to do.
So, Six Flags... 2017.
Six Flags disappoints.
Yeah.
It's just not bringing it. They're not bringing it for 2017, in my opinion. Yeah, so what, 18? What, there'll be another three Jokers.
Yeah, any park that didn't get one will get one. Any park that didn't get a Justice League will get that. And a couple more flat rides.
They really should just announce that now. Get it over with.
They could, yeah.
Because really, I don't think there'll be anything possibly... new and interesting until at least 19.
It seems that way. That's really unfortunate.
Yeah. Unless this is a colossal failure.
Could be.
Yeah, because again, even a lot of casual park goers, I mean, I really think they do go to more than one Six Flags a lot. Not everyone, but a bunch, I think, do. And
And it's not just that, though. People talk to each other. You know, you have friends and family that may live near another Six Flags park, and you talk to them.
I know,
and it's like, oh, you got one of those there. We got one of those. We got one. We've had for a couple of years.
I know exactly what you're saying, and it's a good point. But I think it's actually, you could take that a lot further. That's almost a point from like 20 years ago that you just made. Like, you have friends and family. It's just the internet. It's just everyone's connected these days.
Oh yeah.
So it's like everyone knows about everything else now. I mean, the country is a lot smaller than it was. So. Yeah, actually, I wasn't even thinking about it that way, but sure. Even the way they make the announcements, doing it on the main website. Like, before you pick your individual park, there's the video that's showing off what they're doing around the entire chain. So you're already kind of seeing, like, oh, there's a lot of other parks that are getting the same thing that my home park's getting. So, I don't know, is that good?
I don't think so, because you're making these places less special. If you're just making them all the same...
Yeah.
I understand, you know, all these parks are far from the same. But, like you were saying on the Rumors Show, to have all the new stuff for, you know, like 4 or 5 years in a row be the same, that's really bad.
Yeah, and it's not like people don't know anymore. Because now, you know, it's easy to look it up and find out. So...
It's like anything. You got to diversify.
You do. It's a park chain, but with parks, it's different. It's not like a restaurant.
No, it's totally different.
I understand, like, yeah, every Chili's is exactly the same across the country and has the same menu, but that's different.
It's an adventure.
Different animal. It's a different animal. It's just, it's its own thing. It's only a few of them. There's not a lot. There's few enough that they should all be different.
Yeah, when you go to Chili's or McDonald's or any of these other places, you expect the same meal. I want to eat this.
Yeah.
And you get it, and you like it because you know what you're getting.
Yeah.
But you go to a park, it's kind of like an adventure. You know, you want there to be some unknowns. What is this going to be like? What are they doing next year? What do they have new for this year?
Another big point is that there are so many different types of rides that exist, that manufacturers make, that there's enough to fill each one of these parks with a unique set.
Oh, definitely.
If there were fewer that just existed, like I know 40 years ago when all these regionals popped up, there wasn't so many things. It was mostly Arrow, and it was just whatever. It was a log flume, it was the anti-cars, and it was the mine train. And there wasn't too many other things you could get. So it was more acceptable if the parks all kind of had the same stuff. But there's so much that you can get that why not do it? So there's really no excuse. It's not like there's nothing that's come out in the last 10 years in roller coaster technology that the SNS 40 free spin is the only, it's like, well, what am I going to do? It's the only thing that we could possibly get right now. But that is so far from the truth. There's so many different things they could be doing. Yeah. And mix it up. So I understand you don't have to pick one. You have 12 parks, so to do something different in each one and try all the different things out.
Right. There's not only so much stuff that we just don't have in this country that other parks have that we don't have here.
Right.
There's not only so much of that stuff. There's also just a lot of stuff that's just never been built anywhere ever.
Yeah.
Because these ride companies, they draw up this stuff for a new ride. It's not like every single thing they create gets bought. So there's so much out there.
Yeah, there's a lot of stuff sitting on the table, just waiting to be snapped
up. And you
up.
Could be unique. You could. It's like they don't want any of these parks to say, only at Six Flags, blah, blah, can you get this ride.
Yeah.
They don't want you to say that.
That's like a thing of the past now.
Yeah.
It used to be.
That's really awful. Because isn't that like a real like badge of...
badge of honor.
Badge of pride in the amusement park industry to have something that you can't get anywhere else?
It used to be. It's, I don't know what's going on these days. You got these numbers guys running the show.
Yeah. Yeah, and doing a quick little bit of research here, this John Duffy is a numbers guy. He has an accounting background.
Which is fine, but
yeah.
It's like, he shouldn't be like the creative force behind the company.
Right, but the thing is, right, he's just living up to, you know, this kind of really shitty impression that, you know, you immediately think of, oh, he's just, you know, some bean counter that's making these decisions of what rides are going into the parks.
Yeah.
You know? And he's living up to that asshole image.
Yeah, he is. Just that he's uncreative and lazy and, or just can't even muster it up to be creative. Maybe he's not even lazy, just can't do it. But he puts himself out there in that video and tries to make crack jokes. Terrible.
Any other thoughts?
Holy good God, that's awful. Oh, sorry. Read that somewhere once. All right, so, no, all right, my final thought, I guess, for us, the traveling enthusiasts, I guess I have to say, no Six Flags park needs to be gotten to in 2017.
Not really.
Right? No. There's nothing that has to be done. I'm not going to lie. I'm not saying I'm not going to go to multiple Six Flags parks next year, because I'm sure I will. But I'm going to just go wherever the wind takes me, wherever I may have gone anyway for some other reason. But there's no Six Flags park as a standout for 2017 that's going to pull me in.
Right.
Not even the two co-flagships, not even Magic Mountain or Great Adventure. Both getting Justice League, but getting it 2 years too late. And I can't even be so excited about that. It's just sort of like, oh, okay. It's like, it'll be good when I'm on it, but I'm not looking forward to it. I'm not like anticipating it. It's just sort of going to happen. I mean, man, this is the company that put in Superman the Ride, the original 100 miles an hour coaster. Whatever the hell it's called. What's it called?
Oh, Magic Mountain?
Yeah, it's called Superman Reverse Something Now, right? Because they turned it around.
Superman Escape from Krypton.
Ah, okay. And it was originally just the Escape?
Yeah.
Superman the Escape?
Well, they used to love to get all these wacky prototypes.
They did the Vekoma flyers.
Yeah.
When they were new. They actually weren't first, but Paramount did it first. The other company that loved to do wacky,
yeah,
different stuff.
Yeah, but Six Flags was never shy about trying new stuff.
No.
Yeah, like those flyers, the Intamin Zack Spin.
Yeah.
Rocky Mountain.
You did that first.
Used to love doing that. The new management making these decisions now, that's done, I guess.
Now they love just picking one or two or three things and just replicating it across the chain.
Yeah. I guess by the time, like you said, by the time we get to 2019, they're going to have to do something different because they're going to run out of Justice Leagues and free spin coasters.
Well, it's like, new for 2019, the second Justice League in...
Yeah, he's put it in again.
Six Flags St. Louis. It's like, they'll be like, hey, Disney did it.
Oh, yeah, Midway Mania.
Toy Story.
Yeah.
It's like, yeah, a second Justice League across the park.
Oh, with Midway Mania, and they did it with Dumbo, actually.
Oh, yeah. It's, yeah, I mean, but unless they want to do that, then yes, they do have to, at worst, they have to at least pick three new ride types, and then that'll be set in for 19, 20, and 21. But by then, if history proves anything, they'll be switching management out by then.
Oh, yeah.
No Six Flags management has ever lasted more than like 5 years.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
They have another overhaul. That's pretty much the history of the company.
Oh, yeah. That top slot is a revolving door.
So right now, it's the Reed Anderson. And then now he's like taking more of a, like an, kind of a background executive role.
Yeah, executive chairman or something is his official
title.
So
he's like not so much day-to-day, but I guess he just still oversees things. And then now you have a new day-to-day president. But, you know, you still got the same guy at the real top, I guess, the kind of the executive top. So it's still, I would still consider it that same era, whatever this era is.
Yeah, yeah.
And but no era has ever lasted more than like 5 or 6 years, and then it rotates. So these guys will go eventually, and then there'll be new philosophy all over again, you know, or whatever. Slightly altered philosophy. It's never totally new. I'm pretty sure I've said it on this show before, but yes. Six Flags, the company where... it's like the company becomes you. You can come in as a new manager with your fresh ideas, but you just get engulfed by what Six Flags is and has always been. I don't know what it is, but it's like Six Flags itself is a living, breathing being, and it just consumes you, and it never changes too much. So that's what will happen. Whoever else comes in, Six Flags will become them. All right, so Six Flags 2017.
Go fuck yourself.
We did it. Yes. Go big. Go fuck yourself.
Thanks for writing. Everything's the same. There ain't nothing changed. The sun still shines.